to crumble your construction camp, Nigeria. We will come with it every day here and torment you until you do justice to Martin Luther King. His people is keeping silent because he's a black man. Martin Luther King has British passport. How can somebody be traveling with British passport be kidnapped in international community, abducted and deported? Now the king is a British citizen. My question to Britain, if it is a red Britain, if a red British citizen is kidnapped, what will you people do? If Martin Luther King happens to be a red British citizen, will Britain keep silent? If Martin Luther King or Ahmadu Chagan of Biafra, if he happens to be a white British citizen, will Britain keep silent? We are calling on British ambassador in Berlin. Send this message down to 10 Downing Street. Tell for the justice to do his duty. Tell him to give now the kind of the chance that he gets every British citizen. We all know that when a British citizen is illegally arrested somewhere, or illegally abducted somewhere, British is ready to send their jet fighters. Britain is ready to send their warships. Britain is ready to send down their soldiers. If a British citizen is captured, if a British citizen is kidnapped, if a British citizen is brought to inhuman treatment in any part of this world, why is Britain keeping silent? Is it because Martin Luther King is a black man? Is it because Martin Luther King is a black man? We shall be coming here once every week if it is what it takes for us to get justice. So you guys better not be comfortable in your office, because we will be coming here once every week. Yes, if you take us to come here once every week, we shall come here once every week to spend the time with the British ambassador. We shall do your working hours with you. If it is what it takes, we will come here every day with our microphone, just like our leader Martin Luther King. We will torment Britain till they do justice to Martin Luther King. Yes.
We are facing a threat right now. If we don't do something, that they are going to stop us. They will stop us. We are in a country that has law. They have given us their instruction that we should maintain 1.5 meter distance. We should cover our nose, please. It is very, very simple. We have enough space.
IPOB, I cannot hear you. IPOB, I cannot hear you. You guys are not loud at all. IPOB,
one
family.
IPOB,
please, attention, very important. They just told our national coordinator that they will break this demonstration if we continue to disrespect the COVID-19 regulation, meaning 1 meter distance to each other. Please, can you people spread your hands? And please put your mask on. Spread your hand and put your mask on. IPOB, I cannot hear you. People are distracted here. These are not your friends. Who are these people? IPOB, IPOB,
one
family, one
family,
the answers are disciplined. That is how they know us everywhere in this world. We are disciplined. Please demonstrate the leadership that is bestowed on you. Show that you are disciplined and keep 1.5 meters distance. I beg every one of you, in the name of Chukwu Okrapiama, let us send the devil.
Michael,
show that you are blessed. Keep 1.5 meters distance. So that the devil will not let us go. We came here to do something very important, and we must make sure we get to listen. Our leader, Martin Van de Kano, must be free. Therefore, we must know that we are putting pressure. So please don't let 1.5 meter distance for what we came here to do. Oh, please, every donor coordinator should please identify their members here and call them together. Please, every donor coordinator should identify members here and call them together.
We have already enough. This is enough
to hear, my friend. And this is really going to, you know, if you don't do anything about it, they will cancel what we're doing.
My friend, mind our work, mind our work, please.
Please. Please rise up. Spread yourself so that we can get to our destination without interruption. Keep distance, please. 1.5 meter distance. Keep distance, please. Keep distance, please. Why did we come here? We came to protest and send a message that Mazen Nnamdi the Kanu, Hamadi Kewan of Biafran must be free. So we should not allow the devil to spoil what we came here to do. Please keep distance. Let's show the example of our leading. Because Biafran at the end of the day lead the whole Africa. So please, let's show the example that we are disciplined, that we can obey commands. Let's show the example that we are not like the rest of the million people in the zoo. Let's show the example that we are not the zoo animals, that we are their friends. We are all mutinated. IPOB! We have to let these people know that we are boiling. And we start with a traditional uniform. Nzabu. I cannot hear the leg on the ground. Nzabu. I cannot hear the leg. Let me hear the sound of your leg. Please, you want to send a message. You want to send a stronger message than the Jews do. We want to send a better message than the Palestinians. When we start saying, this is a very important song that sends a message of our mood. So I would like to hear the sound of everybody leg. I would like to, when we start singing this music, in order for this place to share, I would like to hear the sound of everyone, everybody that is here, the sound of your feet on the ground. They have to, I want them to have the feeling that we are 10,000 here.
Yes, for we are
Nzabu Nzabu
Yenimba Yeni
Nzabu
Yenimba Yeni
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 Ohe
Yafa
Ohe
Yafa
Small it. Anybody that is not participating in the program we are doing, sending this message. People start them and you visit that person in the night. I promise you. I hand over to our brother here.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra.
Chineke, I'm here. I bet all of you, majority of you, not me. We are having an issue here. And you know, Berlin police have always been so friendly to us. But what is happening today here? 1.5 meter. Very simple.
Don't be this man. Let's obey this man.
You can push your bear first.
No, bear first.
No,
bear first.
Please again, don't forget what our leader told us.
Yes.
We must always obey instructions.
Obey instructions.
And please, tell your neighbor 1.5.
1.5.
Okay, Baba, bless you.
1.5K.
If you have well articulated speech to make, please start getting prepared. Start getting prepared for your speech. And please let us know. But before we continue, we are continuing by saying to the United Kingdom that in 1965, I was 5 years old.
Look at everything.
And Britain tried killing me. I was among those little kids with such long, thick stomach. I survived, but 2 million little kids of Biafra origin died. Today I'm 55. You know the worst thing? Britain is still chasing me, holding my neck, about to lynch me, killing their friends on daily basis because of free ride. Britain, we have come here to beg you today, and we mean it. Come and take the food oil and give us our freedom. That's all we want. You tell us Christianity, we accepted it. Then you turn around and went to other religion and prepared them killing us. I have some questions for you, Britain. Why, even if you are a mosquito, why do you like the blood of Biafran children?
Yes! Ask them!
I wish you come up and answer this question. Do you know the worst part of it? British women, one of them is called Catherine Lyle. She's a woman.
women. Why do the women feel happy watching other women's children be killed on daily basis and still keep pay? I have more to say, but I will give other people time to put up their own speech. But before I stop, Britain is not innocent! Britain, you are not innocent! Stop killing girlfriends! Stop the poor and give us our freedom!
Oh,
again to our national coordinator.
Please,
the police. We have our faith. Can you people show that you are black friends? Are you people from the zoo?
No!
Are you people from the zoo?
No!
Then let's show that you are black friends. You are watching this way. We are black friends. Marching for our freedom. The freedom of two problems. Now we shall go.
What we need is Biafra referendum. Self-determination is not a crime.
And it's not a war.
It's not a war. A call for referendum is not a call for war. Self-determination is not a crime.
Thank you, my brother.
Nigeria has expired.
Of course.
Nigeria, the
sure,
zoo,
sure,
has expired.
That's all.
Nuclear population has expired. Go ahead, Biafra.
Give me this man.
See how police are escorting us.
Yes, man.
Let's go.
I got To be free today. We need our freedom. Nigeria is end. If Biafra want to go, allow us to go. Nigeria, allow us to go. We are going. So you can see today that no chance in the capital of Benin. For we Biafrans are here saying that we are going home. We need our leader. Free Nnamdi Mazin. Free Nnamdi Kanu Mazin. Now. Free him. He's an innocent man. He's our prophet. He's our Messiah. Free him as in Nnamdi Kanu. He's our prophet and Messiah. free him. Also, I am not one.
Super sport. celebrate.
Let's celebrate. The Emperor has come.
You need that to come on with you.
Send them back to Nairobi. Poor, hungry Kenyans. We are now in front of Kenyan embassy. He don't play with their friends. He don't joke with them. He don't joke with them. He don't joke with them. He don't joke with them, he don't joke with them. He don't joke with them. He don't joke with them, he don't joke with them. Kenya, 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 you're in trouble. You're in trouble, Kenya, you're in trouble. They boycott Kenya women, divorce them, send them back to Kenya. Send them back. Kenya, you're in trouble, you see? Boycott all Kenya products. Anyway, they don't have nothing.